Welcome YouTube land to Ticonderous's action figure reviews, and for this month, for January, I'm going to be kicking off the month with Dark Judgment. So I'm going to do a review of each of the Dark Judges for one each week, in amongst other reviews that I do. But for the first week, I'm going to do the leader of their group, which is Judge Death himself, and then the following week we'll have a look at Fire, Mortis and Fear of the Dark Judges. Now, I'll go quickly on the packaging. He is the same packaging that comes with the Dread figure. It is different to the two-pack one, whereas the two-pack was a bit larger and actually had the Dread, had a picture of Dread on it, whereas you have a picture of Judge Death here in the corner. You have the Judge Dredd logo on the front. These are exquisite minis by Hiya Toys. You can see in the back, his base is still there. I actually have the base pulled out from one of the other Dark Judges. And then just at the back, it just doesn't actually show any images of the figures, just all the legalese stuff. Usually they do pictures of the figures on the back. And just behind the figure itself has the big badge from Dredd himself. So there is a slight bit difference in the packaging. So the figure himself does stand in the 3¼-inch scale. So if I just bring in my tape measure, and unfortunately I don't want my Dread figure with me, I'm going to wait till I have all the Dark Judges reviewed and then bring Judge Dread in himself, because I also have the Judge Giant figure, which is part of this kind of first wave of figures, but I want to do all the Dark Judges together as a kind of a group. Well, not as a group, but you know, individually for each week of the month. So Death himself is quite nicely detailed. I have reviewed a Judge Death figure before, which is this one. This is the comic black and white version. Now, I will say the teeth on the comic version look a bit more defined than the paint job on the painted version. It could be just the way it came out in the factory, but the head is on a ball joint. There is some slight differences between this guy and this guy, most notably being the shoulders. So this guy has his shoulder pad attached to his actual shoulder and can move slightly out of the way for articulation. Same with the pterodactyl shoulder pad on his right arm. Now, it does hinder the movement, obviously, because of the way they're positioned, but for the most part, it does move out of the way. He has a single jointed elbow with a swivel. He has a ball socket for the wrist. He does come with some accessories, which I'll get into. He has a ball jointed waist. Unlike Dread, Dread actually has a segmented waist. He has an upper and lower torso. This guy doesn't. In fact, I think all the Dark Judges don't have that articulation point. He does have kind of a drop down leg. He can kick forward that much, but not back too much. And then he has a dual jointed knee system. He has a forward and back on the ankle and a rocker on the ankle, and he does have the, I said head is on a ball joint, except my one is fairly tight. All in all, he's quite nicely detailed and quite nicely sculpted and put together. I haven't had any real QC issues with this guy. For the difference on the shoulder pad for this guy, it is actually attached here, just above his badge and on his back. And for the actual pterodactyl side, this one is actually glued in place on his shoulder. This has some tiny amount of movement, but for the most part, it does hinder his articulation. And it was one of the things I brought up when I did a review for this guy, because he came with a Judge Dredd, and the Dredd actually had some issues as well. Unfortunately, do I have the Dredd from that set handy? Bring him in for a size comparison. I do not. I thought I had him to hand, but it seems I do not have him to hand. I have him placed somewhere else. So, just for a few size. Oh, actually, before I do size comparisons, because we have some accessories for this guy. So, like the Dark Judges, the other Dark Judges, that is, Death here comes with two additional hands. He has a more outstretched, kind of creepy hand. I'm not sure if you can see that in screen. He also comes with kind of another outstretched hand, which is kind of more of a grasping hand. He comes with this human heart. So the whole part, or if you're not familiar with Judge Death and the Dark Judges, is they're basically from an alternate dimension version of 2080's Mega City 1, where they were normal humans at one point, or they were normal judges at one point, and then they kind of became crazy and decided that because all crimes were committed by the living, then life itself must be a crime. So they went about basically executing people for the crime of life. And one of Judge Death's signature moves is to reach into someone's chest and rip out their heart, basically, is hence why you get a heart with them. And the other thing about these guys is they can't be killed, hence why this version of them looks like this. Now, it would have been nice if they may do it. They might do a colorized version of this. This is kind of more based off the comics. I'm not even sure if I'm pretty sure it was in black and white on the comics, because there is black and white versions of these guys coming out as well, with like of all the Dark Judges, which is interesting because Judge Fire is actually translucent orange plastic, so they're going to do kind of a smoky plastic for him, which will look pretty cool. But we'll get to that when I get to it. But this is basically Death's incorporeal version of him. So all the Dark Judges can't be killed, they can only be contained. So that's why they have, Psy Cubes, I think they're called. They're specially constructed ISO cubes that they contain the spirit energy of the Dark Judges. And I know I'm going way into the lore of it. I don't know if it's been changed since, but that was all the stuff that I remembered about them. That their lore was that they were unkillable, basically. The only way they could actually imprison them was to contain them. So we'll do some size comparisons since I have them here. We'll have these another Hiya Toys figure, which is the Judge, not Judge, the RoboCop figure. We'll bring in my recently looked at Phantom figure. I'll keep it with Hiya Toys and bring in the Predator figure. We'll switch it up a little bit and bring in one of the Jurassic World characters. This is the older Ellie Sattler, and we have the Muldoon, and then we have a 25th anniversary G.I. Joe figure. So this is the Mars Trooper figure from the Mars Trooper Builder set, Army Builder set. So you can see the scales pretty much is pretty much on par with anything that's in the 4-inch scale. He's a little bit taller than anything that is in the exact 3¾-inch, because they're always been a bit shorter, but overall he looks pretty cool together. So there you go, guys. I hope you enjoyed this quick look at Judge Death. As I said, I'll be doing a review of each of the Dark Judges for the first 4 weeks of January for 2023. It's going to be Dark Judgment Day, or Judgment Week, or Month. Dark Judgment Month, as they say. So we'll have a look at those, and in between there'll be other reviews. So hope you enjoy this quick video review for Judge Death. And as always, please feel free to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Cheers, guys.